This is in continuation with the previous lecture of FFT. So what we have studied till now, this is decimation in time DIT FFT algorithm. So I have told you how to compute this. So what will going on here is this, that when we want to compute this DFT using FFT algorithm, what FFT algorithm is doing, it will use the property of symmetricity and periodicity of DFT. So what is this periodicity and symmetry property? I have told you I think in the classroom that it has a properties in the properties of DFT. So there is a unique property, you can find out it here, that what will happen. For example, you will take it this x7. So x7 is there, okay? So you have to find out x7. Then what will happen if you are minus it from this n point DFT, and it is how many point DFT is there? It is 8 point DFT. So x of 8 minus 7, what you will get? It is x1. So it is equal to x1. Okay. Similarly, x 8 minus 6, 8 point DFT is there. 8 minus 6. Suppose you have to find out x6. Then you can alternately find that x 8 minus 6 is x2, which is this x2. Then x2 is minus 9. Similarly, x6 is minus 9. x8 minus 7 is 3. x7 is 3, na? x8 minus 7 is x1, and it is also 3. So this 3 is 3, minus 9 is 9. This x5 is equals to x3. So what will happen here? Whenever you will minus from this whatever is point DFT, 8 point DFT or 4 point DFT, whatever it is, then it will show a symmetric property. You will see it, I think, that it is a symmetry property. Like 3 is 3, this minus 1, 3, minus 9, 3. Similarly, the sequence is repeated, minus 1, 3, minus 9, 3. Okay. So it has symmetric property. Similarly, if you want to find xn by 2 means x by, if it is 8 point DFT, if you want to find x4, then what will happen? I have given you a gate problem regarding that if what is the value of this x4 if it is a 8 point DFT. So it will alternately add minus plus with this sign and add addition of this. X0 is addition of all the sample. Like if you want to find x0, then what is it? X0 is minus 1 plus 0 plus 2 plus 0 minus 4 plus 0 plus 2 plus 0. Why? Because every twiddle factor is 0 0 0 in this. So anything to the power 0 is 1. So x0 plus x1 plus x2. So it is a shortcut that if you want to find in objective problem also, if you want to find x0, then you can easily find out that whichever is addition of this all the sample, it is x0. Similarly, you can exploit this this property. So what FFT have done? FFT had exploited the property of symmetry and periodicity of this DFT for this algorithm. Okay, so if in regard to this complexity of this FFT, what we have seen here, that complexity of DFT previous was n square. If it is n point DFT, then complex multiplication is required is n square, then complex adder is this n into n minus 1. But in case of FFT, we are reducing this n square to n by 2 log to the 2n, and it is similarly for a complex addition. So it is greatly reduced. So when we are want to compute a very high number of, you know, point DFT, then this FFT is very efficient and less time consuming. Okay, तो अब क्या करना है इसमें? इसमें आपने ये प्रैक्टिस करना, देखिए ये जो है ये सीक्वेंस रहेगा, एक के साथ एक पेयर हो रहा है, फिर दो के साथ दो पेयर होगा, फोर के साथ फोर पेयर होगा. सिमिलर अगर ये 8 पॉइंट डीएफटी है, फॉर एग्जांपल इफ यू वांट टू कंप्यूट 16 पॉइंट डीएफटी, देन सिमिलर पैटर्न विल गो ऑन. like 4-to-4 pair is there. Here for 16-point DFT, how many output will be there? It is 16. X0, X1, X7 से फिर X15 तक आएगा. एक और जो आउटपुट होगा, ये नीचे भी होगा इसका. तो जब आप उसको कंप्यूट करोगे तो ये तो तीन स्टेज है. तो 16 में क्या होगा? 16-point DFT में 2 to the power 4. तो चौथा स्टेज में क्या होगा? चौथे स्टेज में ये जो है, ये जैसे 4 के 4 आपने पेयर किए, उसमें 8 के 8 पेयर होता है. मतलब X0 को पेयर करते हैं हम X8 से. मतलब ये तो X0 तो अभी लास्ट में आता है, लेकिन ये जो X0 वाली लाइन है इसको पेयर करते हैं हम ये 8वें लाइन से, फिर पहले वाले को 9th लाइन से, फिर इस तरीके से, और उसको फिर नीचे से 8th लाइन को फर्स्ट लाइन से हम पेयर करते हैं. तो इस तरीके से, और उसी तरीके से जो लास्ट के 8 है इसमें -1 -1 हम ये लिखते हैं, मल्टीप्लाई करते हैं इसमें, और ऐसे ही कंप्यूट करना था उसको. ठीक है, तो ये एक पैटर्न है. फर्स्ट हमने एक से एक को, एक को एक पेयर किया, फिर 2 को पेयर किया, फिर 4 को पेयर किया, फिर आगे आएगा तो ये 8 को भी पेयर करेंगे. बट वी आर डीलिंग विद दिस, वी आर लिमिटेड टू दिस 8-point DFT ओनली. इफ इन एग्जाम इट विल कम, इट इज 8-point DFT, एंड यू कैन ऑल्सो ट्राई फॉर 4-point DFT. यू कैन प्रैक्टिस इट, लाइक इफ वी हैव 4-point DFT, दैट दिस 2 stage विल बी देयर. Because 2 to the 2, 4, and this 2 stage is there up to this. This you will got in 4-point DFT. Try it by yourself. You will get it. That try it by this conventional method also, by putting this formula X0, X1, X2, X3, and also do it by this DFT FFT algorithm. You can easily find out that it is much more this time. Less time consuming in comparison to this DFT. Okay, so practice it, try it for 4-point DFT, and if any problem persists, then you can message me or tell me whatever is problem for 4-point DFT. And this is DIT. So in next, what we are studying, this DIF, decimation in frequency. Okay, so here what we'll have, there's similar thing is there, but in DIF just we have to, this pattern is reversed. Actually this X0 it will here, but this will reverse here like this. And one more thing, it is decimation in time, so the time domain sequence will be out of order, but frequency domain will be in order. Okay, in decimation in time, in decimation in frequency, opposite will happen. What? This time sequence will be in order. Whatever is in any question, XN, you will simply write in sequence. But we will write, you will write it this like this. What we have write in this paired, because we are doing here what, decimation in frequency. So it is decimated in frequency. It is out of order in frequency domain, but it is in order in time domain. So that is why it is known as decimation frequency. And similarly, what we have this in last stage, what we have in this last stage, we are having it in first stage. So here also it is 8-point DFT. You have to go through this problem through DIF FFT and compute DFT using FFT decimation frequency algorithm. Okay. So what will happen? This first 4 will be paired with last 4, and similar operation will be done. This -1, -1, -1 will be multiplied in last 4, and this incoming signal, and just arrow will be reversed because this is the final stage. Here it is, but here what will happen? This arrow will be reversed because omega 8 to the 0, 1, 2, 3 is here, and it is after this stage. So it is reversed, get reversed from previous one. So you have to remember this sequence, and similarly this 2 will be paired with 2, like this is in second stage, and this whatever is coming downward, this -1, -1 will be multiplied. Here also -1, -1 will be multiplied, and similarly total factor is multiplied. In the last stage, what we'll have, we will paired with 1, 1, 1. Okay, and -1 will be multiplied at the second one. So it is similar to this. Just reverse this pattern. This pattern we will reverse first, in DIT, there's two to this 1-to-1 pairing, then 2-to-2 pairing, then 4-to-4 pairing. Here it will be reversed. It is first 4-to-4 will be paired, then 2-to-2 is paired, and then 1-to-1 pair. So, and but this output will be out of order, this x0, x4. So you have to remember is it that decimation in frequency is implied that it will be decimated in frequency domain, not in time domain. And in DIT, it will decimated in time domain, not in frequency domain. It is in order in frequency domain. So in this way, you can compute it, this decimation frequency algorithm, FFT. Okay. So I hope you will understand it. So practice it, because just you have to rot it down. Actually, it is it will not exactly right to say you have to rot it, but you have to just remember the sequence. What will happen that like 4-to-4 pair is there, -1. I just first time saw it and follow the pattern, and I just didn't force myself to remember it. It is automatically came to me, because just follow the pattern, just remember it logically, so you can easily get it and practice it by without seeing it, by remembering in mind also. It is it is a correct way of studying, that you have to practice it without seeing, without taking some problem, without seeing it the solution. So you have to solve it, so you will ultimately know where you are lagging and work on that your lagging part, and you will ultimately, because you can't fool yourself, practice it by yourself, by becoming honest to yourself, and you will ultimately know where you are, your limitation, and work on that limitation. And I hope that you will understand everything that I have told you. Just practice it and you will get it ultimately, what I have told you. And still any doubt is there, then you can message me, call me, and give some this comment in Google Classroom. I will definitely try my best to sort out your problem, and I hope that you are learning and studying well. Okay, thank you very much.